Good afternoon. When we think of the U.S., we often imagine the cities, New York, LA, Chicago. But the reality is that it's a vast country with thousands of acres of farmland that we don't always see on TV or in the movies. And since the migration to the cities from the late 1800s through World War I, there's been a shortage of farm workers who plants and harvests all the crops in the remote areas of the U.S. There aren't enough people, and that's why the H-2A visa exists. Today, we're going to talk about temporary agricultural workers. Let's say that a farmer is in the position of harvesting a particular crop. He realizes he isn't going to have the labor necessary, and he wants to hire people legally and pay them fairly. First, he is required to initiate a regional recruitment effort through the State Workforce Agency. If he still can't find enough U.S. citizens to carry out the work, he's obliged to bring workers in from another country. That's when he applies for a temporary labor certification for H-2A workers. Once the certification is approved, agricultural workers from the USCIS-approved countries from around the world can apply for H-2A visas through the Department of State. Approved workers have an agreed arrival and departure date on record, and the terms of their visa are unique. Workers are guaranteed to be paid 3/4 of their workable hours, even if there is no work to do. And the agricultural organization pays for their travel, housing, and sometimes food. The limit that the H-2A worker can stay in the country is usually 3 years, but this restriction has temporarily been lifted due to the coronavirus. In conclusion, the H-2A visa provides agricultural workers from around the world with work and U.S. farmers with workers to cultivate and harvest crops. If you are new here, make sure you click that subscribe button and check out our other videos. Thank you for the privilege of your time. We'll see you next time.